That is Angelia, Richard Marks. News and sport to come in 10 seconds at 4 p.m. This is BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 4 o'clock. This is Lisa Costello. Thousands of people in Edinburgh have lined the streets in silence to watch King Charles and senior members of the royal family walk behind Queen Elizabeth's coffin as it was driven up the Royal Mile. A service of thanksgiving for the life of the late Queen is underway in St Giles Cathedral. The Reverend Callum MacLeod opened the ceremony.
We gather to bid Scotland's farewell to our late monarch, whose life of service to the nation and the world we celebrate, and whose love for Scotland was legendary.
Queen Elizabeth's coffin will lie at rest in Edinburgh before being moved to Westminster Hall in London on Wednesday. Those who want to see it have been told they may need to wait for many hours, possibly overnight, and there'll be little opportunity to sit down. They'll also need to go through airport-style security. Palm Sandu is a former chief superintendent at Scotland Yard. She says she's never seen anything like this.
I don't ever remember London expecting to be full in this way, even with the Olympics. Because it was staggered over many days and you had the different events across the country, it's never, ever been a particular locality that's been full. The numbers that are expected are going to be higher than the funeral for the Queen Mum and also for Princess Diana's funeral.
Downing Street is inviting people throughout the UK to observe a one-minute silence at 8 p.m. on Sunday. It said this would provide a national moment of reflection on the eve of the funeral. In other news, a 35-year-old man has been jailed for life for carrying out an unprovoked machete attack on the London Underground. Ricky Morgan will serve a minimum of 16 years behind bars for the incident at Green Park Station, which left another man with serious injuries. The mayor of Ukraine's second city, Kharkiv, says electricity and water supplies there have again been cut off due to Russian airstrikes. Moscow admits a number of villages have been retaken as Ukrainian forces continue a counter-offensive in the northeast of the country. General Sir Richard Barons, a former commander of the UK Joint Forces Command, believes the Kremlin could turn to nuclear weapons if threatened further.
If President Putin felt that he was being presented with an existential defeat that threatened his regime or the vital interests of Russia, then according to their own political and military doctrine, that's when they might reach for these small nuclear weapons. The effects of those nuclear weapons would be terrible, but very localised in Ukraine. But the political dynamics of that clearly way, way more important.
People aged 65 and over in England can now book their coronavirus booster jab online or via the 111 helpline. The NHS is also offering appointments to carers and pregnant women. Around 26 million people will be eligible for an autumn booster in the coming weeks. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past four.
Thank you. Thank you, Lisa. Live sport from BBC Salford show, Joe Sarker.
Good afternoon, England. Cricketers are celebrating winning 6 out of 7 test matches this summer after beating South Africa by 9 wickets in the third test at the Oval. Ben Stokes's team needed just 25 minutes to get the 33 runs they required this morning. It's emerged the Williams F1 driver Alex Albon suffered respiratory failure at the weekend and was treated in intensive care following appendix surgery. The 26-year-old had an operation on Saturday, but he suffered post-operative anaesthetic complications and was put on a ventilator. Albon is now back on a general ward in a hospital in Italy. Arsenal's Europa League match against PSV Eindhoven on Thursday has been postponed. That's due to police resources in London being stretched as the country continues to mourn the Queen. A revised date has yet to be announced. Meanwhile, the FA has confirmed that the WSL and the women's leagues below it, plus the FA Cup, the national leagues and grassroots football will resume as scheduled tonight.
Thank you.